So thank you for inviting me here, and I apologize first for my English, which is not so good. First things I want to say, I come from northern of Italy, from the city of Turin, where I live, and I'm a militant of a social center, and I'm part with my group in this movement, which is mainly based in the Susa Valley, which is the major line to go from the northwest of Italy to France, especially to Lyon and Paris. First of all, I want to say that I like the framework on which this discussion began yesterday and continues today, this idea, notion of crisis regimes, as I understand, is something with a double meaning, which is a regime acting in a phase, in a period, in a context of crisis, but also regimes that are in crisis. And it's something that we could say, which is very specific also and paradigmatic of the Notav struggle. And also the other issue that I heard yesterday from the introduction, to think on crisis not only as a tragedy, but also as a possibility of inventing new forms of living, new forms of life, new forms of struggling together. Here we talk about the Notav concerning what you have called the ultra neoliberal urban development. When we talk of Notav in the Tav project, I will especially talk about the line between Turin and Lyon, which cross this valley. The Tav project is a part of the TEN, Trans-European Network, which is a European project of high-speed railways, which is divided into 11 territories, and the one concerning the Susa Valley is starting from Lisbon and arriving from, and is supposed to arrive in Kiev in Ukraine. But at the present time, for the last news of the last years, is that Portugal and the most part of the Spanish line, they renounced to the project because too much expensive, and also Ukraine renounced to the project. So there are 11 corridors, and this one is the fifth corridor. And already it's important to keep this notion of corridor, which is something like the territory, the land where this train will pass, are just think like something to be crossed by, and with no relation with the territory, with the people living there. So here it's interesting to see how this project concerned also the city of Turin and this transformation. And another point is how the local of this struggle has been a point, a starting point of gathering people together to oppose this project. And for me, the most interesting is how in the last years this movement has became, the issues of the movement has grown, and now talk of something more than just the opposition to the highway, high-speed railway line. When we talk of Turin, we talk of the fourth major city of Italy, a town that has been, that have had a long history of determined by the car industry, the Fiat, that now is finishing in a way, still finishing. And the administration of the last decades, of the last two decades, especially of the last one, think the transformation of the city only as a city of leisure, of a city of big events, cultural events. Especially we have the example of 2006, which is the Olympic Winter Games. I think you in Athens know what does it mean to have an Olympic Games in your city. And now it is the first or the second most indebted city of Italy, public debt, for these games and also for the big use of derivatives that the administration made. And this is why the political forces, the major parties, are the true bigger supporters of this project. And they think that this project will bring new life, new economy, new job to the city. There another fact that is really important to remark is the architectural, the financial architecture called project financing that permit to use a big cash flows of public money to finance this major public works, this major infrastructure. We talk about a line that is about 30 kilometers in Italy and 40 kilometers in France. This is the part of the line in the mountain that will be very impacting the environment of the valley. With this project financing, they say the tough supporters say you have the possibility to allocate the risk and let the risk be assumed by private investors. But in the Italian declination of this project financing is the state that put the big money, the cash flows, and the private investors just took the profits. It was good the example that Mark made yesterday. He made this scheme. This visual representation of banks, mass media, local governments, central government, building companies, property owners, and real estate agencies talking about the housing question in Spain. And more or less it's the same talking about TAF, with the difference that you don't have the banks that put the money, but it's the fiscality of the state that put the money. The real estate agency could be seen as the parties, the major parties, especially the Democratic Party, which is the so-called Italian left, and the property owners could be the organized crime, which are the lower level of building the line. This is, I can read just a witness of people who come in the valley and make this document. They say, what we have understood by visiting the Susa Valley, they say, a place already crossed by two state routes, a highway, a tunnel, a railway, sky resorts, every impacting mining industry along the river. People who keep taking care of the exploited territory, heavily affected by infrastructures and commercial business, and who try to maintain a balanced relation with their own environment and culture. A community united by strong ties of conviviality, social cohesion and solidarity between generations. We have understood that what is at stake in the Susa Valley is not simply the making of high-speed railway between Turin and Lyon, but an entire social model, a united and consenting people, a strong community cannot be subject to any political or economical interest. But all the strong powers of economy have interest at dividing and isolating its members in order to control and protect particular business. So, I have no more time, as I can see, but this is a movement. The project is a European project. The major line in Italy has been already constructed. But in this part of Italy, there is a long resistance that lasts since 20 years. And since 15 years, you have a big mass movement which have had a long moment of struggling against the local and central government. And we have had a block of highways, clashes with police, mass demonstration in order of 10,000, 20,000 people, and so on. And now is one of the major preoccupation, political preoccupation for the government, because it's a movement deeply rooted in its territory, but it's becoming something that speaks to the rest of Italy, because its capability of lasting in times, its capability of uniting, gathering people together on this, on the target to stop the line, to stop the construction on the line, and especially, we could say, especially in the last 2 or 3 years, as the government put more force, more strength to repress this movement, we have had 5 years of pause, because we won, in a way. In 2005, we arrived to stop the project with big fighting, clashes, occupation of lands, occupation of highways, and so on. Since 2010, the government came back with a big militarization of the valley, and the movement now is grown up. It became a sort of point of reference for many movements in Italy. It's situated in this valley, but many groups of supporters is now widespread in Italy and also in many other parts of Europe, France especially, but also Spain, also Switzerland, also Germany. And the question is, the movement has been able to put on the discussion 3 main points, which are who decides, so the question of decision making, and also express the, what we call in Italy, the crisis of delegation, which is the crisis of the political parties. The question of the model of development, and so the question of sustainability, and the question, you could say an economic question, major question, who pays, which is how to use the public wealth, because it's really a vortex of cash flows that is used to. And so one of the slogan the movement says in the last years is, how does it cost 1 meter of TAV project? It cost maybe a room in the hospital. How does it cost a kilometers of TAV? It maybe costs many schools that wouldn't be safe. I did just some data about the cost. At the beginning, in 2001, it was 70 billions per kilometers. Then it became 90 millions per kilometers. And now for the part of the line which is more or less 50 kilometers underground is rising up to, in the provision, 235 billions for kilometers. But if we take the, if we see what has been the construction of the Turin-Milan line, which is on a ground level, in the years of the construction it has risen up of 600%. So it would make the provision 235 billion for kilometers, 6 times, 7 times more. The last thing I want to say is that it's a movement that has been long, which is strong, which is in a way isolated, because we don't have any other big movement that have been able to last. And so there is a big repression and a big militarization of the territory. Just to make an example, the chief of the police of Turin make a report at the end of the December and says, we apologize to the people of Turin because we don't have too much police for the city, because the 80% of the police of Turin is busy in the valley. And what is interesting for me is how the movement has changed and how the movement has put together other issues. And now we have interesting phenomenon for me, which is what yesterday Maria said, the unconventional social mix. That is something that point emerges in this struggle. I mean, a lot of, not only militants, a lot of militants which come from different groups from all over Italy in the moment of big struggles, but also younger peoples, people who is unsatisfied by the parties, especially by the left parties. And another point is the need that this movement express in a way, as many other contemporary movements, the need for having a space to gathering together, a space to organize, a space to live, a space to fight. And I would tell the big need for a change of paradigm to this movement express and feel to be connected with other movements like it. Excuse me for being too long.